Sekarang kan kita dah ada Perdana Menteri baru.
Dengan PH pun saya berkawan, dengan PM pun saya kawan. Tak ada bisnes yang tak mencabar. Mesti ada mencabar.
Dalam perjalanan Dato' Din membina bisnes AirAsia kan, properti lah, tadi ada studio lah, produce lagu lah pula kita dengar ni. So ada tak masa-masa yang paling mencabar, menurut Dato' Din, masa-masa yang paling mencabar saat membina bisnes sepanjang hidup?
Bila you go through business cycle ni kan, tak ada business yang tak mencabar. Mesti ada mencabar. That's why bila saya cakap nak buat business ni, you kena buat business yang you're passionate. Jangan tiba-tiba you suka rambut tapi you kata, alamak, inflation orang tak potong rambut kan, you buat restoran. So you buat, tapi bukan you punya passion tu. Jadi you buka restoran tu thinking that it can make money. Passion you potong rambut thinking you cannot make money because orang tak potong rambut during inflation kan. So makan orang tetap makan. But the fact is, makan restoran ke salon ke akan ada dia punya own challenges. Tengok-tengok orang yang buat restoran tu yang memang suka masak ni, tak buat duit pun tak apa, dia suka masak,
dia happy.
Dia happy and then dia kata okay, maybe resipi dia tak cukup buat. Dia cuba improvise bagi bagus supaya orang makan. So dekat situ dia punya passion, eventually dia berjaya. That's why you notice kadang-kadang orang buat bisnes kadang-kadang lepas tu 2-3 bulan tutup sebab interest tu tak ada. But if your interest is there, you will work towards making it a success. So that's the key rule number one. Buat bisnes benda yang you suka. Then after that, lepas you dah suka, nak buat bisnes tu, tengok apa kekuatan you, apa kekurangan you. Okay, but yang mana kekurangan you, either you hire atau you cari partner. And then you pun kena tengok bisnes apa yang nak buat tu, market tu ada tak? Bila market tu ada, realistik lah. You jangan short sendiri.
Tahu.
So you say, oh aku nak buat ni. Tapi market tu tak ada, jadi you short sendiri je. Sampai bila kan. So you tengok market tu ada, tak ada. Kadang-kadang orang kata, okay tak apa, tak apa. Spend kan. Because dream saja. By the time you habis, memang benda tu berjadilah because you dah spend. Tapi how many times you dengar cerita orang, dah duit dah habis. Pergi kat bank tak ada. Tapi company tu, sayang ni dah nak jadi kan. You start jumpa orang, this business dah ni ataupun kontrak ke dah nak dapat, tapi you dah tak ada because you tak manage your cash flow. Itu yang business yang bagus about to meletup, kena jual. Proceed your business, as you go through your business, dia pasti ada challenges. Terusah business, in your life pun pasti ada challenge kan.
Betul.
Tiba-tiba you sakit, tiba-tiba family you tak ada duit. I've always said, in fact, I told your husband daripada dulu, startingnya, don't look at challenges as a failure. Challenges is there to actually educate you.
Tentang pasal bisnes lagi, Uncle. Dia macam seronok kalau dengar Uncle share tentang bisnes kan. Tapi, kalau lah Tia sebagai Uncle dan tiba-tiba lockdown, lepas tu tak boleh nak flight, Tia mesti menangis, Tia sedih. Tia mesti, alamak nak buat apa. Uncle tak ada rasa macam tu saat itu?
Tak adalah. It gives you opportunity for your family. A lot of the family businesses arise masa COVID ni. Ikhlas.com tu kita start pun masa COVID. Ishraq buat start property ni pun masa COVID. Now we are doing, insyaAllah lah, kita nak buat agriculture business pun semua masa COVID. Because masa tu you get to spend time with them. So masa COVID ni you don't have to cross border. So macam Ikhlas my neighbor kan. So they just walk over. So kita cerita. So things develop masa COVID. So hikmah. You get more family time. Then you get to spend time with them, you get to develop new business. So right now, so each of them have a business. But to get the family to support, the family must be his partner. So family tu dengan dia a partner. Dia ada dia shareholders,
sama-sama. Right?
Jadi kalau dia berjaya, adik-beradik dia pun berjaya, okay. Sebab family tu ada situ. Jadi nak tak nak, family will support that business. Because family also a shareholder. That's ni lah.
Itu atau Uncle mengajar keluarga Uncle macam
so
tu?
So that dia orang rapat, dia orang support each other. Yes.
Wow.
So insyaAllah tak adalah bergaduh-gaduh.
Betul.
Lepas tu tak ada rasa iri hati. Dia berjaya kan? Aku punya bisnes tak berjaya, dia punya berjaya kan?
Faham?
Pak yang ni dia berjaya pun tak apa, aku ada share.
Ya, yeah, macam semua.
Jadi apa aku rasa? Kalau yang ni tak fair pun, yang tu kata, alamak. Dia punya fair, mesti kita kena tolong. Sebab kita pun ada share.
Faham.
So insyaAllah dia ni. InsyaAllah. Insya kita tak boleh tahu kan.
Betul.
Jadi itu my way of getting them to support each other. Sebab I tak nak bila I tak ada nanti, dia orang start bergaduh. The last thing I want to do bukan saja ada beradik, but even with Tony is bergaduh pasal money.
Yeah.
It's important. Benda-benda ni important. Even in your business, I keep telling, make sure you business tu pun, you pun kena bayar zakat. You pun kena bayar zakat. Hmm. Because kalau you punya business sole proprietor pun, you ada partner. Don't forget, you ada partner. Your partner is Allah. Itu pasal you get carried away. Apa sahabat aku nak share? Ini aku punya business. Aku tak ada boleh kalau you ada partner 50-50, okay, kau setengah-setengah. Jadi, kau nak beli rumah, ya? Aku pun nak ambil duit tu nak beli rumah because kita partner kan? Tapi you must always think Allah is your partner. So Allah is your partner because you boleh buat macam mana pula effort you lah kan? Jadi bila you fikir macam tu, you allocate untuk Allah as your partner. Tapi Allah tak memerlukan. So you allocate pada jalan Allah.
Uncle kan cakap kalau kita buat bisnis, kita dengan passion kita yang kita suka. So dengan Uncle buat Alicia ni, adakah sebenarnya Uncle suka travel?
It's actually all about lifestyle. Kan aviation tu lifestyle, you travel. I buat hospitality kan, there's Tune Hotel, ada Omen Chow Kit, telecommunication, kita ada Tune Talk. So kita ada financial portal because it link. Kan, so you boleh gunakan credit card when you travel. So it's about lifestyle. Then kita start ikhlas.com, it's about lifestyle. Tapi how can we have lifestyle tapi still manage our Islamic values? Kan orang nak pergi China takut nak makan kat mana, nak semain kat mana. So ikhlas.com will provide you kan Facebook, you pakai Instagram,
YouTube.
You buat YouTube. Now I'm trying to start with YouTube lah. I'm beginning to learn about YouTube.
Betul.
Tapi insyaAllah
dia kena update tak ikut semasa. Dia tak
ikut
boleh
semasa.
Kita guna dulu, nak guna sekarang. So you okay, dah subscribe ke belum ni?
Subscribe.
Din Meranun Vlogs, ya?
Subscribe, orang tua punya vlog. Sebab dia orang kata, dia kata, yalah, even Mikey cakap kai. Alamak ayah, you punya vlog tak interesting, orang tua. Cakap, apalah, whatever. Don't buy by then. You ada, you punya, you. Tapi sampai bila you nak entertainment dia? Mine will have useful information.
Betul. Okey, Dato' Din, mengenai tentang macam sekarang kan kita dah ada Perdana Menteri baru.
Okey, alhamdulillah at least we have a Prime Minister lah daripada dia hanging kan. Masa because kita berkawan dengan semua. Dengan PH pun ada berkawan, dengan PN pun ada kawan, dengan Barisan Nasional sebab kita in business. So you cannot pick your size kan. I don't think anywhere in the world pun you see businessman. Maybe some lah kan, but I'm doing business bukan dengan kerajaan. Lesen tu kerajaan mana pun patut bagi because I'm giving back to community. You know what I mean? I'm giving this low cost carrier. Dulu mana Sabah Sarawak nak travel kat sini? Ingat government started ferry Malaysia. Tak jadi. Sebab nak integratekan Sabah Sarawak. Today Sabah Sarawak dengan Malaysia ni tak ada different dah.
Betul.
Dengan Semenanjung. My proudest moment is bila sekali tu I tengah jalan dengan Najat, tengah jalan dekat KLCC, sekali ada budak kecil dua orang lari peluk. So macamnya ini anak siapa pula tiba-tiba ni kan. Tapi mak bapak dia kata peluk uncle, because thank you uncle, because without Asia dia orang takkan dapat tengok KLCC live. Dia orang tengok TV. So that is your proudest moment, you be able to contribute to society kan, rakyat dah. So macam benda ni lah. Jadi tapi kita bukan ambil contact government, bukan ambil ini kan. Kita go direct to the market. You know what I mean? I tak ada supply chain. I cakap, okay government aku supply ni, tak ada. So whoever the Prime Minister, if they can appreciate what we are doing, should be supportive.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Okay. And then kita, whatever it is, we will try to improve. We will try to, you know. Kalau ada kelemahan tu, kita betulkan kan. Kelemahan yang betul-betul lah, insyaAllah kita betulkan.
Ya, so tahniah juga kepada Malaysia kan, kita dah ada Perdana Menteri yang terbaru.
InsyaAllah.
Kita doakan semoga Malaysia lebih maju selepas ini.
InsyaAllah, stability lah, more stability kan.
Ya.